These two albions riding down the road. One turns to the other one and says, well, how did they get the land in which they have quiet? Referring to the Catholic Church. Guess what this cracker said and looked at him and said? He looked at him and said, the Moors gave it to them through a land grant. This is in the movie. Go get this movie.
Hey, yo, this is straight up from all them niggas out there who fronted on some bullshit in the beginning. Fuck that.
Thank you. SG-Rap, Lord Finesse and Daddy, are you fresh? One of the Hirachis and Jordans hit the mesh. Didn't self-destruct to get him, I just waited. Hearing Jeff transform as he crossfaded. Travel Fox and Buffalino, suits of silk. Bumped into baseball when I went to Bar Mill. He said, no deal, I don't care like D. Leave that to me, she mom is my priority first. Heard Stop Looking, Listen, Love Light, Light. Saw the Power album, loved Ice-T's wife. Digging through the crates, Diamond D, Master Ace. When 88.1 played Apocalypse and Ace. Deal with your case, LL kinda bad. Nowadays rappers show their chest cause they fag. Walls of posters, MCs and posters. What's the boot camp crew chant before Eskoshka? E of PMD brought Red Man to me. Big girl and special ed Tony Touch instead. Cause he dropped the 50 MCs. All of my faves, I levitate this to MCs that's now in the grave. I like to levitate this to hip hop. The five elements run the ish hop. Giving respect cause you all made it. Big up the black dot cause he helped us save. I like to levitate this to the DJs. I like to levitate this to the dancers. I like to scared to say don't touch my ass, you D-ball cowards, try that with me. Ball in the face, no 48 hours, punks and dresses, wearing headbands with flowers. Kendrick Lamar, all boys, bars after hours, they calls with them. Those Negroes with record deals, can't drive their own cars, just spinning the wheels. Faking the funk, not from the main source, stainless rhyming, saying nothing, so it's nothing more than minus. Fronting, started at the top and telling you the bottom. Get a plane in your name if you'll take it in the bottom. No thanks, not trying to be in those ranks, having to sell out my people, but chained to a plank. Blood dripping, sharks all around, swimming circles. End up like pot cause they said that they won't hurt you. Trust them, then the hologram of Tupac busting. That coke on his nose, eating a McMuffin. No listening to rappers, only master MCs. In a B-boy pose when you capture MCs. No tight jeans, worn by my master MCs. Big B's and wood pendants when you capture MCs. No listening to rappers, only master MCs. In a B-boy pose when you capture MCs. No tight jeans, worn by Morris master MCs. Big B's and wood pendants when you capture MCs. Watch out, keep eyes open, it's fake snowing. Malcolm Moore, the best rapper with his Grammy glowing. They're not taking over, blacks just give it away. And wonder why they have nothing and living this way. Uncivilized position, forced on a civilized mission. This in our self-proclaimed race. When the civilized distance and it's cheating the land, gods carry healing hands, bringing lords up to satyrs, assisting clans. No one ever knowing, some telling and showing. Most are only seeing what they're taught to believe in. Dumbing them down, the wrong channel you're choosing. Caught up in sovereignty schemes and always losing. It's a wretched world, axe fanning. Play a whack track and a whack rap from the bandwagon. Zombies jump on like couches and wagons. Or concentration camp fought black painted cannons. Or New Year's dragons, or Saints Day. To drink beer cause they killed Nagas. People lost their minds and they're not getting it back. Rap, e-pills, commercial rap, kill you like crack. When more say it, conscious blacks say prove that. And they still won't accept the proof facts. I'm not feeling too many of these rapping new jacks. I guess that's that of Casanova's beat boom back. No listening to rappers, only master MCs. In a B-boy pose when you capture MCs. No tight jeans, worn by Morris master MCs. Big B's and wood pendants when you capture MCs. No listening to rappers, only master MCs. In a B-boy pose, rapping out the position. No tight jeans, worn by Morris master MCs. Big B's and wood pendants when you capture MCs.
Woo! Yeah. Peace and love to all the Moors worldwide. Happy Holy Day to all the Moors. Happy Holy Day to all the Moors. Honors to the Prophet Noble Drew Ali. Honors to all Moors. Anywhere you're at. Honors to you. Supreme honors to you. I just want to remind you that once they don't curse them out, they're going to get cussed out, because you can't tell the champs anything. You're just going to have to take these slaps. So spread the word. We're gonna be live on Canaan Land Moors YouTube, 4 p.m. I already talked with some Moors. Any other Moors out there, you want to get down with the scalping, the Indian scalping today, bring all your facts, whatever you got. Bring all your facts. We'll see how many hours we could be on there today. and beat up on these Indians since we're the champs and nobody can tell us jack. 4 p.m. Kenyan Moore's YouTube. It's the Indian beatdown by Moore's, just to show you that we know exactly what we're talking about. Right, we know exactly what we're talking about. 4 p.m. If you have a free minute and you were reading a book or something like that, you got something to share with regard to the Moors and the Indian crap that these people are pulling, bring whatever you got. Bring whatever info you got. Bring whatever. It doesn't even matter. So 4 p.m., Kenan Land Moore's YouTube is the Indian beatdown, the scalping of the Indian crap, since the Indian people want to play games with Moors. Fine, we're going to entertain you today because we're the champs and you can't tell us jack. So this is the kickoff. This is the kickoff for 4 p.m. It's going to beat up on these Indians talking crazy.
Are not from here. And I just can't wait till they're destroyed. They're the devil that Bible speaks about. Facts.
They are not Moors. And y'all motherfuckers did not build this country. The Indians did. We did. Everything y'all came here, you learned it from us. That's what I'm saying.
They're the devil that they're not from here. Moors are not from here. Moors are not from here. And I just can't wait till they're destroyed. They're the devil that Bible speaks about. Facts.
They are not Moors. And y'all motherfuckers did not build this country.
Let me find it. Something long. It's just a reader. let's see. I found it. Assert it. Says Americans who belong to the Moorish side of America claim to be descendants of the Moors of Northern Africa. They are not. Oh, yep, I found it. I'm going to read this case for y'all. I found it. The Supreme Court done already made it a goddamn decision. Bay versus State. Let me blow this shit up. See, I don't give a fuck what books they read. Once you hit the U.S. courts.
Right. So once they're talking about, they don't give a fuck about books. If they're saying they don't give a fuck about books. Right, they don't give a fuck about books. These people are incompetent. And again, this is for the two in the back, because we already know all the bandwagon goofballs. We already know they're not getting off the wagon. We already know that, right? This is for the two in the back who are on the wagon, going downhill 100 miles an hour. No barriers on the side. You're just riding along. No seatbelt or nothing like that. Stuff going downhill. 100 miles an hour, bumps everywhere. You already see what's going to happen. You've already envisioned the future. And you're saying, hey, I'm getting off this bandwagon because this stuff is absolutely crazy. So it's for the two in the back. Right? They're telling you out their own mouth. They don't give a fuck about any books that the Moors use. That's letting you know that they don't study. Remember, these are the leader people. These are people with platforms, right? Getting subscribers, right? Using that's how a profile picture looks. That's the profile picture. Yeah. Why they insist on lying to you? Why they insist on lying to you? Must they lie? Do they have to lie? Why are they lying? What's the point of them lying to you? This is John Trudell. Look up John Trudell. Look him up. John Trudell. 600 years ago, that word Indian, that sound was never made in this hemisphere. That sound, that noise, was never, ever made, ever. And we're trying to protect that. The Indian as an identity. We're starting not to recognize ourselves as human beings. We're too busy trying to protect the idea of a Native American or an Indian. But we're not Indians. We're not Native Americans. We're older than both concepts. We're the people. We're the human beings. Right? But niggers who think that they're Indian aren't human beings. Blacks who think that they're Native American, they're not human beings. Because every human being has to have a nationality, even if you're an indigenous human being. Even, the more said in the chat, even the word Indian isn't Indian. That's not Native American. We're too busy trying to protect the idea of a Native American. Or an Indian. Right? What we say to our people. We're trying too busy to protect the idea of Negro, of Black, of colored, of African. But we're not those things. We're human beings. And every human being has a nationality. That's not opinion. Every human being has a national origin. Every human being has four mothers and four fathers. If you're only going to go as far back as to honor your chitterling eating grandmother because she said you're Indian, right? Suzilus. What am I? English mother, Bayesian father. You are what your mother is. But always remember that one drop of nigger blood makes you nigger. Just a thought. Or just a thought. You have English mother all you want. The fact that your English mother got with a nigger, she's black sheep of the family now. Because she cross-contaminated the race and all that. But all that's BS, because one drop of nigger blood, that's not what Moore say. This is what Europeans say, which is why they can pillage the planet. Because if you're not them, you're food. I'll make it real simple for you. It's not hard. It's real easy to get. If you're not them, you're food. Who's not them? Anybody with a drop. If you have a drop of the nigger gene, the black guys, the African monkey men and all that, the savages from the lands of Africa, you have one drop of them in you, you're them. And I'm pretty sure, and this is just somebody in the chat just asked the question, I'm pretty sure they can give you the example of them getting it on both sides. Getting the side where, there might be a little light enough, so we'll let them get in and give them a little thing, but we're not really with them like that. You know, they're a nigger. You know, and then they thought they were on the good side or whatever. Go with the white side because they'll treat me right. No, they won't. One drop. One drop rule. And that's a real thing. I looked that up. One drop rule. That's not opinion. That's not opinion. That's why Drew Ali said, if you try to judge a man from what he looks like, you already messed up. You already messed up. Judging somebody by how they look. So you don't have to fall for that stuff. Because they're going to try to say no. Well, no, but Drew Ali said do not amalgamate, and that means that you're... No, that doesn't work like that. Exactly. That doesn't work like that. No, you missed it. Your nationality is what your mother is. But don't forget, Moors ruled Europe. Moors are dark-skinned people. So don't think because your mom's European or something like that, that means you're a descendant of pale people. Because Moors ruled Europe. You know the Moors? Yeah. Your mom's English. Is your mom a blonde hair, blue eye? Is your mom a blonde hair, blue eye? Anything other than a blonde hair, blue eye? Anything other than a blonde hair, blue eye? The blonde hair, blue eye is, that's the mold of the modern European. Absence of melanin. Right? None in their hair, none in their eyes, none in their skin. That's a qualification. Right? Now, certain Moors would look at it that she's coming back home by getting with your dad. Because she already knows that if she has an heir with another blonde hair, blue eye, that child's not gonna get too far. They're not gonna get too far. Your mom could be serving out a karmic debt that she came back as a blonde hair, blue eye because she did some BS when she was Asiatic. And she's back here now. And gonna correct the mistakes. And first way you're gonna do that is get the nigger gene in you. But don't get it effed up that because your mom is a blonde hair, blue eye, that you can't be the origin of them. Blonde hair, blue eye. Because the real blonde hair, blue eye is the albino. You know the albino? They have no melanin in their hair, no melanin in their eyes. And they're some outcast or whatever like that because they ain't supposed to look like that. And where is their... And all that stuff. And then you see now they're taking people who have it because it's a genetic defect, and then it shows up on their face and it shows up around their eye or something like that. Now they got them modeling and all that stuff. They used to murder albinos. They used to murder albinos. Now they got them in damn commercials. And so the cycling. The cycling of humanity from no concentration of melanin to the darkest dark people that you ever seen in your life. There's all that is the quote-unquote original people. From the pale, the albino, that's a nigger that doesn't have any nigger in his skin, in his eyes, in his hair. But they don't look like the European with the blonde hair, blue eyes, and whatever like that. With that, they show you know, He-Man and all that stuff and say the original man for them. Right? Conan the Barbarian and all them. Right? They're separate from the humanity. Right, the blonde hair, blue eye that they say was in the caves and all that stuff. The albinos weren't in no cave and all that. They were still around the Asiatics. Right. So we just don't want you to be, you know, thrown off. Because your mom's a modern European, so that means the Moorish thing has no connection to you or something like that. Because your mom was onto something if she went and got Asiatic as a mate. Whether it was her personal whatever like that she didn't want to mate with some blonde eye, blue eye like her, or some spiritual divine thing. Why? Something was up for her to say, I ain't even messing with no damn stuff like that. Right? I'm upping my game. Right. Generational curses breaking. Generational curse is breaking. And I'm sure if you talk to your mom, they say, why you with a nigger and all that? I know, you know your mom got it. Especially if she's a blonde hair, blue eye. Oh, you know she got it. They ripped her to shreds. Especially when she's pregnant and all that stuff. Oh. Oh my gosh. Your mom got it. It's bigger than some skin complexion. That's why going back to tell you about the one drop rule. Now don't think because the mother side is European that you're getting some pass or something like that. You're nigger to these people. They don't care. Right? You're not going to be accepted as on the European side. You're a nigger. So it'd be wise, since it's a one drop rule, that you resonate with your own. And your own is the Moors. That's your own. Not the Indians and them guys, not the blacks and them. None of them. They're not your own. Don't trust them people. Don't trust them. Don't trust them. John Trudell, July 18th, 1980. History is a weapon. We are power. I'd like to thank you all for coming to this place. And I'd like to give thanks for being welcomed here myself. And I would like to talk tonight in honor of all of us in the struggle who have lost our relations to the spirit world. I would like to talk in honor of the wind, one of the natural elements. This is a survival gathering. And one of the things I hope you all learn while you're here is to appreciate the energy and power that these elements are. That of the sun, the rain, and the wind. I hope you go away from here understanding that this is power, the real, only real, true power. This is only real, true connection we will ever have to power, our relationship to Mother Earth. We must not become confused. We must not become confused and deceived by their illusions. There is no such thing as military power. There is only military terrorism. There is no such thing as economic power. There is only the economic within these illusions, so we will believe they hold power in their hands. But they do not. All they know how to do is act in a repressive, brutal way. The power. We are a natural part of the earth. We are an extension of the earth. We are not separate from it. We are part of it. The earth is our mother. The earth is a spirit, and we are an extension of that spirit. We are spirit. We are power. They want us to believe that we have to believe in them, that we have to assume these consumer identities and these political identities, these religious identities, and these racial identities. They want to separate us from our power. They want to separate us from who we are. Genocide. Genocide is just an intellectual way of saying murder, because we live in a so-called civilized, industrialized world. And because this world is allegedly civilized and allegedly has laws, they can't go out and call an act of murder murder anymore. They call it genocide. to throw another illusion in our eyes. And they have limited our ability to see the necessity of our survival because they want us to believe that genocide just means physical extinction. We must consider the spiritual genocide that they commit against us. The spiritual genocide that the white people, quote unquote, have been victimized for thousands of years. The spiritual genocide that told them not to respect the earth. The spiritual genocide that told them not to respect the life that is on the earth, but to pay all their tribute through the churches to God and heaven, that heaven would take care of them in the afterlife. They tried to take and suppress our natural identity, our natural spiritual connection to the earth. You still not convinced? Because we're not gonna go through all, we're not going through all this. We're not going through all this. If you don't get it from that, then you're done. You're done for. Stick a fork in them. It's over. These people play games with you. Because that's what they're about. Playing damn games with you.
Defendants, appellees, Marion County. All right. John Jones Bay, plaintiff, appellant, versus State of Indiana. John Jones Bay, pro se, Aaron T. Kraft, attorney. Okay, why is he fighting in the United States court? I'm done. Office of the Attorney General, Indianapolis, Indiana, for defendants, appellee, State of Indiana, Eric Holcomb, Pamela Screaman, attorney, Office of the Corporation Counsel, Indiana, for defendants, appellees, Marion County, Posner, Circuit Court Judge. Kraft, attorney. I don't got to read all that. Let's just get to the good part. Okay. This is the circuit judge. John Jones Bay. Okay, here we go, y'all, with the bullshit. Smash the like button. Who describes himself as an Aboriginal. Shit out. Aboriginal. Indigenous. Moorish American. Get your fucking laugh on. Filed in the district court. This is federal court. What he labeled of mandamus, seeking to enjoin state and county officials from taxing real estate he owns in Marion County, Indiana.
I know. You see that the bay was the plaintiff. You see that the bay filed writ of mandamus with the court. Court accepted it. There's the transcript right there that they're reading. They found a transcript. Well, if they call him bay in the transcript, wouldn't that mean that they know who the Moors are? Why didn't they call him a straw name, John Jones? Why'd they put the bay in there? If the court's criminal and they don't do stuff right and they whatever, then how come the people who are partaking, how come they can't see with their own eyes that, hey, the district court accepted him saying that he's bae on the court records? I thought they didn't know who the Moors are. I thought the Moors were sovereign citizens and all that. If they're sovereign citizens, would they be letting them file some papers in court? If they're criminals and anti-government and all that stuff, you gotta watch out for them because they're the ones that are paper terrorists and all that stuff. Then why'd they let him file his case in court? Is a kangaroo court, legit court, colorable court? We don't care what court it is. But we do know that he was the plaintiff, which means he took them. They didn't bring him there. Now, he's a plaintiff, then that means he took them. And people sue all the time. This is not some Moorish thing. Go to court, you're just saying, oh, that's a Moorish thing. Moors go in the court and they're the... What? Everybody uses the court. You go to court and they have stuff all day in 20 different rooms. Everybody uses the court. So what are these people talking about? A Moor going to court as if the Moor doesn't have a right to use the court for something. How they're warping you? Because what are they going to be arguing about? This European broke the treaties, the indigenous treaties. They were Indians. Indians in the Constitution. They can't do this. They can't do that. Any of them go to court to prove their position? We're talking about the nigger Indians. The black Indians in them. We're talking about them. We're not talking about the red man. Them people. We're not talking. We already know they go to court. We already know they go to court. When they get wronged or whatever, we know they're gonna lay down in front tractors and all that to stand up for their stuff. And they're gonna bring out their Mohawk flag or their First Nations flag or whatever it is that they got. And they're gonna stand on their stuff. They're gonna chain their stuff to railways. The red man. But these nigger Indians, they're not going to do anything. They're just going to get fat. They're just going to get fat. The Indian Associates. The Indian Associates of the Moors. The Indian Associates of the Moors. They're a fraud. They're a super duper fraud. How are they talking crazy about the Moor who's standing up for his right, not for his property not to be taxed? He has a right. If they don't represent him, but they're taxing him. Because he's saying, I'm a Moor, so I don't need you. Okay, but then they're taking the tax. Then that's taxation without representation. Which he should be taking them to court for that. How are they mad because the Moor is taking the colonists to court to try to not get taxed in his own land? Why are you mad? Why are you mad? Unless they're the agent. They're the sellout, not the Moor going to court, standing up for his rights. But don't worry. Don't worry. 4 p.m., Canaan Land Moors. All the Moors, if you're free, we're going to put the link in the chat. And you know, every Moor could get their swing. Their swing at the piñata. Every Moor could get their swing. 4 p.m. Canaan Land Moors YouTube. Honors to all the Moors. Happy Holy Day. Will the day goes great. Day is great. About to go get fat now. Have the championship lunch with the championship drink. And then just gonna be do a championship chill. And then 4 p.m. Who knows? Might get excited and you might see us before 4 p.m. We'll see how it goes. Because we're the champs. We can do what the hell we want. Honors to all the traps out there. Honors to you. Don't forget, you were part of this. You were part of this. Right? Know that you are part of this. So you're a champ too. Don't let anybody tell you different. Especially today. Because, you know, it's the day after. It's the day after, and, you know, the champagne wore off and stuff. And it's in history. They can never take it away. It's in history forever. Forever. 1,000 years from now. 1,000 years from now. It's going to be there. So honors to all the Moors worldwide. We'll see you on Canaan Land Moors YouTube later for the Indian beatdown. Right? We're going to play them like their drums later. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. We're going to stomp on them like they're powwow dancing. That's what we're going to do later. Honors to all the Moors. Happy Holy Day. Of course, honors to the Prophet, Noble Drew Ali. Supreme honors to the Prophet, Noble Drew Ali. Islam to all the Moors. 4 p.m. 4 p.m. You know, just find your way to Canaan Land Moors YouTube. We're gonna do the Indian beatdown. It's that time. It's time for them to get it. It's time for them to get it. It's been a while since they got slapped. Honors to all the Moors. Honors to the Prophet Noble Drew Ali. Honors to all the Moors in the chat. Don't forget, Moors, you're champs. We got this. Peace and love to all the Moors. Islam.
Rituals for damn near anything you want to do, and we can give them to you tonight.
Hey, Chris V. Still get it from the intellect reservoir. Cosmic surfing, these two sons of God didn't come from virgins. Ether makes up these gods. We rode light angles to the earth plane. Again trapped in skin but a different name. Monads, been here since Ruth and Moabs. Thought you killed me when Drew and Marcus got toe tagged. That's why I'm here with the grand chairman of fear. Truth make you think critical like severe. Doing the God things, I make ancients appear. And all I'm hearing is knocking while I'm watching a seer. Ancient rituals and sound healing notes through pro tools. Eye to eye transfers knowledge, you need no schools. Waking up the masses, music is classes, stage. Most fail cause they look like the flying shades. Following demons possess Kanye's and Lil Wayne's. Expecting a hippie with a cross and a Greek name. In the melanin cause me D&B, the late cup with no cheese. Orisha's in me, I'm not what you don't see. I'm not one of those armchair revolutionaries. Allah's in me, sick and tired of being sick and tired. But that's just where we get our strength, man. The Christ is in me, I'm not a hustler, pimp, gangsta, gangsta, but trust me, they all in
me. I got it when the moon shifted the tomb in the melanated womb. Sipping milk in the honey, doing triple black, boom. Touchdown, traveling on planet Earth where we crush clowns. While I'm managing this curse and preparing the elixir that turns copycats into kitty litter. These poor pussies pretending to be misters. I cannot sin, but I can be very sinister. My limitations are limited as I do a lap around the galaxy. Had to gather light and rally back and fuck the fallacy. And cause of that, I got labeled the antagonist. And it didn't help that I cuss and burn cannabis and burn candles and wear symbols of Orishas. And I put a hex on the heads of seven preachers with one trailer spit aimed at the pulpit. Crush the crucifix, a whole tabernacle backflip. I'm not Catholic, but if I choose my bare resonance, you may just catch a glimpse of Lucifer's semblance. Up and down Jacob's ladder with my melanin, the vessel of no fear none, you can find the devil in.
God's in me, I say that so serious. Turn a nigga to a god, show you I'm serious. I ain't got him proclaiming, name changing and facing with no guilt or fear. All these clansmen, masons, we stand on squares, circumscribe our own circumference. Goddess Lakshmi, bless me with abundance of prosperity. I speak with clarity, not to confuse. Put Moorish in front everything, from Christian to Jews. I'm the anchor, so I don't listen to news. On some snail type vibrations, making me snooze. Calling a parker to call down our UFO crews. Like Yahweh or Dogon shamans, we call on Ra Amen. For sun ritual, spiritual, I'm physically trapped. Rewind playback and get your pioneer tap. Like Gregory Hines, when I'm spitting the rhymes. A&Rs want me to blow, but all rights reserved when we sign. In the melanin calls me D&B, the late cup with no cheese. Orisha's in me, I'm not what you don't see. I'm not one of those armchair revolutionaries. Allah's in me, sick and tired of being sick and tired. But that's just where we get our strength, man. The Christ is in me, I'm not a hustler, pimp, gangster, wankster. But trust me, they all in me.
Alright, so let's put a libation on the guru. Olensu, Shula, Otija, Chieja, Cheola, Alcala, Loteo, Kakomo, Lalula. I need some Lala shades. Issa, Amonu, Noku, Mana, Inmatu, Tuti, Juba, Joba, Egati, Nasimbo, Nisaba, Isala, Alvilu, Tazu, Tuba, Lumare, Alonia, Ida, Ido, Elvis, Grandpa, Notorio.
James Stang.
Futuristic. I'm feeling bionic. I'm puffing this chronic. I'm drinking my tonic. I'm rolling like Sonic. I'm Johnny Mnemonic. You niggas don't want it. You niggas don't want it. Said you niggas don't want it. You niggas don't want it. You niggas don't want it. I'm always defining. Got a plan that's atomic. You niggas need phonic. All you know is ebonic. Cause your flow is melodic. You think you iconic, but you really just not it. I'm in the tropics, blazing exotic. Listening to chronics, isn't it ironic? They call me Jane, I'm a Morris electronic. They call me demonic. Say I'm Masonic. Cause the fez on my head is what they dread. And they know it's Islamic. You plague, you bubonic. You Adrian Adonis. Sprinkle gold dust and they rush to get sucked. And you feed them hypnotic. Don't do that.
Oh, you mean don't do that? Show me some boy looking in my ball flat.
Don't do that.
Oh, you mean don't do that? Show me some boy looking in my ball flat.
Don't do that.
Oh, you mean don't do that? Show me some boy looking in my ball flat.
Don't do that.
Oh, you mean don't do that? Show me some boy looking in my ball flat.
She says she like the way we roll, but she really love the tree goes. Well, I tell her, only know that she amigos. Remove that before I get evil. Before it done, I always reload. Tell her anywhere we go. We do it easy like a free throw. And we not talk chain when we see evil. When we see evil. We not talk chain when we see evil. Free throw. Hot so cold before zero.
I'm a king in my palace. I'm a mirror, I'm a mallet. I'm holding no malice. Wonderland, I'm with Alice. I'm puffing my chalice. A young gun, I'm like Chavez. Where's Elion Gonzalez?
They force you to funnel a boat or a tunnel I use for my passage. No compassion, they savage. Rape, pillage, and ravage. They try make you vanish. Want toss your salad, or language you speak is not only Spanish. Why they act so outlandish? Wearing spandex with their man purse and their man dress. From a vantage, I peel off like Speedy Gonzalez. Mom said I'm too mannish. My depression is manic. Cause they try tell you lie to your eyes. And they want you to panic. From land you get banished. No food, you feel famished. Without a bed sheet, you try be discreet. But you call her still clannish.
Don't do that. Are you mean? Don't do that. Shut the song, boy, look him in the my bar fly.
Don't do that.
Are you mean? Don't do that. Shut the song, boy, look him in the my bar fly.
Don't do that.
Are you mean? Don't do that. Shut the song, boy, look him in the my bar fly.
Don't do that.
Are you mean? Don't do that. Shut the song, boy, look him in the my bar fly.
She says she like the way we roll, but she really loves the dreamy bones. Well, I tell her, I only know that she and me close. Remove me before I get me more. Before it done, I always reload. Tell her anywhere we go. We do it easy like a free throw. And we not touching when we see evil.
Let me show you how we do stuff around here.
Actually, my department uses Monday.com, so I'm good.
The work management.
The shadow box, the shadow box. You close mind and then you boxed in. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman.
This hoverboard rap. Thank me now, you're welcome like a floor mat. Beat my format, tarot deck, I sort that. Pulled the magician, now you see my forecast. Royal palace in the crystal ball. I'm a fully spitting bullets, that's John Wall. We dialing up classics and it's on call. How you bounce back after the fall? That's a question. We building, not finessing. You got complaints or suggestions? Decided law is my reference. Y'all decorate. The essence is my preference. No hesitation with the demonstration. On my back is where you find the nation. No hesitation with the demonstration. On my back is where you find the nation. Shadow box, the shadow box. You close minded, then you boxed in. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman. The shadow box, the shadow box. You close minded, then you boxed in. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman.
Step into this ring, the gods of war sing. Drum steady pounding to the bloodstream, coursing. Heed their warning just before the sword swings. Move north 4 degrees, avoiding its sting. Listen to their voices, sight unseen. Quiet all the noises, focus on just being. I am one with the breeze that eases through the trees. I am one with the earth underneath your feet. I am water walking land in the form of man, the king of Siam. Am that I am, I'm that fire that's burning deep inside your heart. The synchronized senses moving your body parts smoothly with fluidness. Highly intuitive, knew the movements of your fists before you even did. With each step left, right, feeling oddly compelled. Cause the shadow box with God is to spar with the self.
Shadow box, the shadow box. You close minded, then you boxed in. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman. The shadow box, the shadow box. You close minded, then you boxed in. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman.
Recognize your dark aspects, I don't mean skin tone. Outside truths in the house, demons you bring home. Outside clothes on your bed, sleep with a night hag. Paralysis when you sleep, dreams every night bad. Subconsciously suppressed aspects, acts called job. About negative behaviors, unravel is done. See the deepest trauma and guilt you push away. Causes depression, addiction, and anger you display. Identity is central to the practice of magic. Witchcraft help you rewrite and conquer your habits. Detrimental to the growth, exploring the shadow self of man. Learn to less abandon. vanish with pentagrams. Get a black candle, a pen or a pin. Scratch shadow emotions, let the healing begin. Light it and meditate, burn it down to the end. It's locked in. This is what we call shadow boxing.
The shadow box, the shadow box. You close-minded, then you box deep. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman. The shadow box, the shadow box. You close-minded, then you box deep. The shadow box, the shadow box. Perfect your craft, become a marksman.
Islam Moors. Peace to all the Moors. Peace to all the Moors. Honors to all the tramps out there. Honors to all the tramps. Peace and love to all the Moors who know that we're winning. Honors to you. Honors to all the Moors in the chat. You have to listen. You have to listen when Moors talk. Stop playing around with Moors. Stop playing around with Moors. This is your people. Rotting them. And they found somebody's auntie. Now they got her as the empress. The empress of the whatever. They're a tribe. They're a tribe. Right? These people right now, these are people right now who, they're collecting their, they're collecting their 100,000. Right? Oh, their goal is 1,000,000. Sorry. I didn't count a zero there. Their goal is 1,000,000. Right? And then you could donate to them. You could make $1,000 donation to the Kiro Haka tribe, whoever's. Right? These are the authority people that they're saying are the ones to listen to and follow. These are the ones. Right? But if they're part of a incorporation that's called a tribe, right? They're not a tribe of people that need to trace them back 8,000 years, and 8,000 years ago they were in the bushes. The little grass skirts and all that stuff, eating fern and doing whatever they do in the bushes. Like the tribe people. The tribe people, those are the bush people. Those are the bushmen. As soon as you hear tribe, in your head, picture the bush people. You know when they say the bush people on the continent, and then guys come up and then and all that stuff? You don't know what the hell they're talking about? Bush people. This is who these tribal whoever's are. I want you to get it. I'm going to beat you in your head with this bat right now. Called Tribes Are Corporations. Tribes are corporations. A tribe is a corporation. Anytime you hear somebody pop up and they say tribe, know that that's a corporation. Without a shadow of a doubt, don't be confused. They brought out the orange feather. And the orange feather is the feather from the ancestral As soon as you hear tribe, automatically, in your mind, think corporation. Why does a tribe have to deal with Department of the Treasury and Internal Revenue Service forms in order to be... I thought you're here before these Europeans. Who's giving you these forms? Department of Treasury, that's not indigenous thing. Why they go into them? You know how they like to say, well, the Moors go to court, and the court, where's the Moors court? Does you know how they talk like that and try to put that stuff on Moors? Most of the times Moors goes and go in court because somebody did something to them. Moors wouldn't want to go there if they don't want to. Anytime Moors in court because they're violated. The only reason they're going there because somebody violated them, and more than likely it's probably some modern European from some department of whatever claiming that they have authority over human beings when they're a corporation. Just like these tribes are a corporation. So when you go filling out forms with them and giving them finance, they're taking those receipts and they're getting their finance back because they're a corporation. You didn't give them anything. They're getting double. So because once you're a corporation, you get breaks to get the finance back that you're spending. So when you see them go get some stadium to do some sovereign conference of the whatever, they're getting that finance back that they spent. They're a corporation. They're not a tribe like you see the people come out with it. They're not a tribe like that. These are people who started a corporation and then told people come join their corporation. We're going to say that we're the tribe of Cahokia whatever Indians. Right? Oh, they brought the white feather. Their purity. Why use the white feather if they're black Indians and all that? They're using the white feather for. Don't they tell Morris, don't use the white man's dictionary? Oh, use the white man. That's the white man's dictionary where you got that definition. Well, how come these indigenous people are using a white feather? Doesn't that mean European? Because that's how it goes, right? If playing the black-white game, anything white means Europeans, right? So if anything white means Europeans, why are these indigenous people repping for some Europeans right now? Or are they using white because white means purity? And if white means purity, then how some people who's murdering your ancestors white and you're not? When you're the founders of civilizations. If you want to play dumb, Morris could play dumb too with you people. Morris could play dumb too. And either way you go, you lose. Because all these people are fraud and everybody knows what's up. Everybody knows. And they're either a sellout trying to keep you away from where you're supposed to be, which is in the Moorish paradigm, with honoring Noble Drew Ali, recognizing what he brought, and giving him his honors that he's due, that he never got. Because people didn't support him back then. It was just the true faithful Moors that kept this thing alive. No one else. And it's the same true faithful Moors today that are keeping this stuff alive, that you have somewhere that you can go to find out about Moorish stuff. Because none of these niggers are telling you about Moorish anything. Nothing. All of them are pushing their, fill up their Cash App. And then you like a dumbass, you're putting in your number. And then in 2 months, you're getting fraudulent stuff going on in your account and all that stuff. And you're talking about some dark web people, hackers or whatever like that. No, it's the same dumbasses that you just gave your finance to. It's the same dumbasses that stole your information that you just gave to them, funding their BS when you're struggling. You can't figure this stuff out. They'll be running up and down, filling out papers, going to powwows, doing all types of BS.
Moorish.
Yeah, the my fans Moors ain't no Moors.
Acknowledging
we the never United acknowledge States you, the Moors.
From Morocco.
Great, Sister Beth.
And that's a fact. Okay. I'm not taking no bullshit lies. And don't tell me that the empire that was under the water was Moorish, because there wasn't even a little sign that survived under the water to say, oh, Moorish Empire, bullshit.
They gotta take us off the land. That's taking us off the land. Whether you go with Nibiru, with that Sumerian bullshit, because that ancient Sumeria is bullshit too. It's not older than America. People are got that really confused.
Right. What these people have confused is they think that America is some beacon of whatever. The world was that when we were running shit. You could go anywhere in the world and some dark-skinned people are going to put you on game. That's why we say Moorish. Because when we say Moorish, we're talking about world culture. We're not talking about these people's little pocket. They never even left America. How are they talking about they know something about the world or about themselves? They haven't even left America. We're talking about the Indian whoever's. They haven't even left America. But they know what's going on in the world? Even if they don't call it that, when the Indians go dock their canoe, that's called mooring. When the Indians go dock their canoe, that's called mooring. They don't always lift the canoe and bring it out the water. Sometimes they dock the canoe. You might not feel like lifting it up that day. We'll just tie the canoe to this tree right here. We'll be back. You know, walking through no jungle with no damn canoe on your head. What dumbass stuff is that? You're gonna dock the canoe. So Moors are talking about world. Everybody else is talking about their little pocket. And then making claims that they're the authority of something. How are you the authority of something when you're only talking about your little pocket? The Indian whoever's are talking about a little pocket. Because all they're talking about is America. When we talk about Moors, we're talking about all across the world. You're not going anywhere else in the world and seeing some Indian shit or whatever. Unless it's like the Hindustani Indian. But other than them, you're not finding no Indian stuff anywhere in the world. That's only in America. Do you realize that the only place that you hear about Indians is in America? You know that? You know when you talk about Moors, you can find that anywhere in the world. When you talk about Indians, you find them only in America. Who's the found? Who came before who then? They're so feeble-minded. They think a continent is an island. This is why we say these are bush running through the jungles, people. We're not denying them their savagery that they call history. No problem. If that's who you say you are, if you're black Indians and all that, and your tribes and all that stuff, hey, do your thing. Just don't say anything to Moors. Just do like your ancient ancestors. See Moors and just see them. You're hiding through the bushes, looking through the leaves and all that stuff. And you're seeing Moors like, I don't know what's going on over there, but they got ships and people in clothes and, you know. Because they know. You think they don't know? You think that the Indian whoever's don't know that world? Like we were saying, Moors go to powwow. Because we're the indigenous people. Moors go to Indian events. Because Moors are the indigenous people. When Moors go to Indian events, the Indians are telling the Moors, you're the founders. When Moors show up at the Indian thing, these people don't care about no black Indians when they show up. After they sit down and build with Moors about treaties and violating of treaties and all that stuff. And Moors are telling these people, why don't you guys enforce the Treaty of Peace and Friendship? And stop playing around with these Indian treaties. Yeah, you're right, you know, but the chief, because the chief sold out all of them, any Indian whoever's that we talk to. They can't do anything because their chief's been sold out. They don't even have a choice. They don't even have a say in the matter. They don't even have a ballot. Their property. And their chief is the master of the wards. The warden. The warden of the wards. They call themselves tribes or whatever like that. They can't say jack. And that's the red ones. So if the red ones can't say jack, the black ones definitely can't say jack. Because we don't even hear them talk how the red man talks. The red man's more socially conscious and aware of what's going on in the world than the nigger Indians. So, again, once the Indians start talking, their dialogue is limited to America. But there's a world out there. Yes, America is the old world, yes. But America is not the only old world. America is not the only old world. And the Aborigines of America, they're cocky. Super arrogant about being some founder or whatever, but then all they're showing you is teepees and boat carved out of a tree trunk. That's the height of their civilization, mud hut. The mud hut is the height of your civilization? You're telling me about your founders of something? Stop this BS. You haven't evolved from a mud hut? It's not even the bushes and the jungles. So we don't have to deal with you people. But here they come, sticking their head out their hole.
And you know, it's just something people say. We're just so used to hearing bullshit that we don't know the truth. When Samaria ain't older, Mesopotamia, all that, it's not older than America's legacy. It's not. So, talking about Nibiru, now you're putting us in the air jurisdiction. You're talking about Atlantis, now you're putting us in the sea jurisdiction. Taking us all everywhere but the land.
How's saying Atlantis taking you away from Atlantis is land? How's Atlantis sea jurisdiction when Atlantis is a landmass? That's not ocean. Atlantis is not an ocean. That's a landmass. This in the bushes, nigger, is trying to convince you that Atlantis is the sea. Somebody get the all helmet for these people. No cap. All helmet. Just put the New York logo on a helmet for these people. No, you'll be able to convince them that it's their hat. You don't worry. Atlantis is water. That's a lie. Atlantis is a landmass. Atlantis is not some sunken in the ocean landmass. That's not what Atlantis is. Atlantis was a landmass.
And then when we do get on the land, you'll want to talk about more. And you know, well, that's in Morocco. Come on now. Let's just keep it simple. It's confusing. That's what it is.
No, they're confused. It's not confusing. They're confused. It's not that it's confusing. Like I said, more. That means Morocco. But if America is also Morocco, because they'll agree that America is Egypt, right? Wouldn't they agree that America is Egypt? If you talk to all these Indian whoevers, they'll agree that they found Egyptian things in America. Right, well, that would mean that America is Egypt if they found Egyptian things here. If America's Egypt, why can't it be Morocco? Both of Egypt's North Africa, just like Morocco. Egypt's over there, just like Morocco. So how does Egypt have the monopoly on being placed in America, but nowhere else can? Only Egypt can. Egypt's North Africa, isn't it? So, they're confused. And don't let them put their confusion on you. Don't you dare let them put their confusion on you.
Very confusing. And Morocco ain't even... The Morocco that they got, and what is it? Arkansas, or what is it? That Morocco trying to say that was Morocco.
It's not even
a
state. But okay. It's not even a state. It's
a little town.
Peace.
And bust this. The same fucking town they claim to be Morocco, the federal court system said, you ain't no fucking more. You are African American as society views you as, but they were very clear not to pin it on them.
Right. So Moors are African Americans. We're not Moors. Right. Moors are African Americans. We're not Moors because the federal government said that those aren't Moors. They're Africans. But they could be Indians and not be considered African American when they look just like Moors, who they're saying are African American. Does everybody on here look the same that has a picture on here? Yes. So they also could be called African American by federal court, whatever. Because they look the same. What we're saying is if we want unity, the name that we can call ourselves so we can be unified as a people is more. nothing else gonna work. It's just that simple. Nothing else has worked. Look at the conditions of our people right now. The brands don't work. The tribes don't work. How about we try nationality, like everybody else in the world? Stop playing games.
Yeah.
So yeah. Peace, I'm peace. Like, get the fuck out of here.
Yep.
What's up, Buka Amaru?
What's up? Salute, Sister Becky. I got a question. Have any of y'all traveled outside of America? Specifically?
Nope.
I have, but I wasn't doing no Morris nothing. I've been out of the country, so. Well, what's the point?
Specifically to Latin America, I would say.
No, but I got enough Latin America.
To the West Indies. Yeah.
How about this? Nope, I have not gone to Latin America, but I got enough of Latin Americans in my damn family tree.
And I've been to West Indies.
To know that none of them identify as Moors.
Right, no Latin Americans identify as Moors? Well, if no Latin Americans identify as Moors, why in the fuck are there Alhambras of Latin America? Alhambra is Moorish. That's not Indian culture. That's not Cherokee and Algonquin culture. Alhambras are Moorish culture. Why in the fuck does Latin America have Alhambras? That's supposed to be across there, right? That's supposed to be over there. That's supposed to be over there. Is this not true? Isn't Alhambra supposed to be over there? Okay, well, if Alhambra is over there, then why is it in America? Alhambra's over there. Of all the cultures in the world, why did Latin America decide they're going to adopt Alhambric designs for their homes? Moorish castle in Argentina. Why is this not an Indian castle? If the Indians is where it's at, shouldn't there be some Indian castles around here? No, the Indians are berry gatherers. The black Indians, when they go dress up, go do their Mardi Gras and all that BS. When they go do all that BS, those are the bush people. The Maroons running away from slavery. Now you got to live in the bushes. And then the Moors are walking around, going to the restaurants and now using black fountains and whatever like that. And you have this thing messed up. Indians are always bush people. They're the founders of civilization. They were the grass skirt whoevers. Those people wearing silks and all that. To kill a bear, make a coat and all that BS. More has the bear stuff with the cape. What a coat. We don't need a coat. Have the bear head as the helmet. They're playing games with you. And you let them. You keep letting them. You keep letting them play freaking games with you. Keep letting them play games. Practices of resistance in the Caribbean. Practices of resistance in the Caribbean. Joseph T. Farquharson. Seamos Moros, let us be Moors, is what Cuban national hero Jose Marti wrote in 1893 in support of the Berber uprising against Spanish rule in northern Morocco. Who you think? These people with this little platform can speak for America or Jose Marti? Fake hair, three neck lady, five chins and all that. You're riding with them instead of Jose Marti, who's Cuban and said, let us be Moors. They don't know who the Moors are. We're not Moors. Well, Cubans say, let us be Moors. How come they're not saying let us be Indians? How is it that they're not saying, let us be Indians? Why is it known amongst anybody who knows Jose Marti that he spoke on let us be Moors? Because they were supporting the Moroccans fighting Spanish occupation. The same way they over here are fighting colonial occupation. And the Cubans said, let us be Moors to support our Moorish brothers over there. You're going to say they know that they're Moors. Something's wrong with these niggers over here playing black Indian games. They're the ones that are the problem. And don't debate Moors. Don't debate the source. San Bernardino Sun, volume 44, number 79, 31st of May, 1916. Moorish America. What kind of people do live in South America? The Spanish, the Portuguese, but chiefly the descendants of these European races who have intermarried with the Indians. Other nations have made lesser contributions. Brazil, which is only a few days by steamer from West Africa, is one-third Negro, the crudest type of Negro on the American hemisphere. There is a strong mark of the Moor upon the Spaniard. The Arabic Moor wrought his customs very deeply into the life of Spain. The people of Mexico and Cuba might be called Moorish Americans rather than Latin Americans. The customs, manners, and heart experienced in these people of Latin American is more Moorish than Christian. It's more Moorish than Christian. Right? So if an Indian is going to tell you that Moors are more European and African, that's their opinion. This is San Bernardino Sun, volume 44, number 79, 3rd of May, 1916. This is before Noble Juali. where it's recognized that the Spanish-speaking people, the Latin Americas, are of Moorish descent. Their customs, manners, and heart, these Latin Americans, they're more Moorish than Christian. But these sellouts are going to tell you they don't know who the Moors are. They're a liar. That's all they do is lie in order to push their narrative, which is false. Which, when you really do the research, you find out that it's all European psychology. These people are thinking like they're slave masters. These people's mindset and mentality is just like their slave master. Which is why they all end up falling on their sword. Thought the Moors is still here. If it was up to anybody else other than Moors, our people would not even exist. We would really be the beasts of the field still. But the remnant of the Moor is what keeps this going. That's what keeps this going. The fact that there are individuals who know the truth about their nationality and about their birthrights. They know the truth about their nationality and birthrights. They know the truth about the prophet of the Americas that came and told all of these people playing these brand games that you're not those brand names. You are Moors. And like Asir said, whatever you call yourself, that's up to you. If you want to play games, hey, do your thing. Do your thing. Just know we don't play that BS. We know who we are. And we'll continue to unify with other Moors and keep this going as we're supposed to. There's no way we can let that incompetence reign. There has to be a balance. Right? There has to be a balance. You can't just listen to the incompetent people all the time. Sometimes you have to actually listen to the ones who can show and prove. Right? Like. We can show and prove championships. We can show and prove championships. We can show and prove we can inspire people to be the best that they can be. We show and prove it. We don't just talk. We don't just go live to talk. Right, you're gonna see alive, and then Kush is at the barbershop. He's not there for haircuts. That's his trade as a Moor. But this is the Moor's trade. No social number needed, no license needed for whatever. Doing his trade. Free. Free. We're dealing with the colonists and all that stuff. Just doing his trade. That's real. That's not just a you know, 500K online personality, whatever. Like, Moors are actually real. Moors are real. It's not some online thing. This is life for real. Indians, it ain't real for them. It's a charade. It's a front. The conscious whoever's, it's not real for them. It's a front. Not who they really are. We pull up at their house right now. They'll be out there eating pork chops. Pork chops, smoking the Morias. Talking about conscious or whatever. They're not smoking weed. Smoking the Morias. Only. Those are the people who are going to be running your... Please. Stop the dumb shit. Honest all the Moors. All the Moors who know the truth about who we are as a people. Honors to you. Give yourself a round of applause. Because you mean something. You might not think you mean anything, but the fact that you know what's up, you mean something. Know that you mean something. You're an integral part to this whole thing. And you heard the call. Don't be listening to all these false prophets and all that. Don't be listening to them. There's only one prophet for the Americas. And there was nobody that was claiming prophethood pre him. And all you see is people claiming prophethood after him. As far as the Americas, yeah, they were high priests and whatever like that. Ain't nobody claiming no prophet for Noble Drew Ali. So honors to you for hearing the call of the shepherd and knowing the truth about your nationality and your birthrights as a Moor. And not get caught up in the games and staying true to the cause of uplifting our people. Because we all know that we were once Negro black color too. And if we could get out of it with our hard-headed ass, then anybody should be able to get out of this stuff. Well, honors to all the Moors worldwide, all the faithful Moors, honors to all the mothers, supreme honors to all the Moors in the chat. You already know. And don't forget, Aurora, Colorado. I'm going to be out there this coming weekend, Friday, Saturday, lectures, you know, bringing it back, you know, online, whatever. Come build with the Moors. Let's really get some stuff done. Let's really show some unity. Right? No matter what school of thought you're in, we're bringing it back. Whatever school of thought you're in, let's build. The first stop, Colorado. Love, Truth, Peace, Freedom, and Justice Tour, 2024. Honors to all the Moors worldwide. Honors to the Prophet, Noble Drew Ali, the mastermind, the supreme ruler. Peace and love, Moors, Islam.
Yo, Grand Sheik, man, these fools is pissing me off. I already told you not to entertain these fools. this, man. What's wrong with you?
You know I got him.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, it's getting to a point where I'm ready. Yo, it's just some button cut shit I'm on, bro. Straight button cut.
In the scope.
Any violation, you already know what it is. I ain't even into no long talking. I don't even have to bring the thing for them. But, yo, them fool y'all have to know their self and know their place.
You guys are killing yourselves. Always looking for a way out. Only way out is your hard work. If you don't do it yourself, it's not gonna happen. You're not gonna sit there and fucking listen to sellouts that's gonna help you get to where you need to get to. These weave-wearing, fat, lazy people.
Tung Shimitar left the shoes, dirty moors are beneath, replace the mother's head, have a carry the wreath. Traders with cock eyes and coffee stained teeth, smoking a bogey. Wrote a book with Rami, thought he's my homie. Now he's flying cartoon flags, dancing like a drag queen. Whale face, when you look up what a fag mean. Camera or big face, look up treason. Stay in the Canaan land, but not seen at Temple 5 meetings. Using our address, disrespect is callous. See me and look down, eye contact, lesion paralysis. Moore's begging to light him up like Aurora Borealis. Instead of dropping rolls on them, drop a Moorish palace. Halt, smash to dust, blow away like blunt trash. Trader Moore's so dirty, lips have a cunt rash. Claim they leave the station, saw the punks pass. Butler Moore's claim consul general, flashing a badge made in China by a Taj Sharif Bey dick rider. Selling false promises to die by witch fire. Burned at the stake under a heaping pile of Mahdi. The smell would be disgusting, but make me happy. Don't drink enough water, watch out the lips chappy. Lying on Drew Ali, belly yellow like Aki. When Dirty Moore's ambushed, they spit on, but never slap me. Not even a punch. These online talking shit punks using Zooms to sell a package. 35 racks, violate Zodiac and Divine. 35 straps, tied to a pole. 20 more for selling your soul. Use a fire hose when trolls spraying the trolls. Head kicked like a field goal. See me like a peephole. Keep you part and partial so you never be whole. Online scholars nowadays play a unique role. Sell a package to the right more, buried in a deep hole. Wrapped in plastic, call them Snickers. Using my name to upload titles, got them triggered. Zombified in their lives, out eyes, fallen skippers. Abandoned Moorish ties to be spies for Vickers. Ladies in the red dress, call Hayes and Calloways. If they had obeyed, they wouldn't be dragged through the alleyways. I'm not cordial, thrown in a portal for immortals. Negro bystanders think it's paranormal, but it's formal. We don't argue or quarrel. Dirty Moore should get touched for acting clitoral. Stroked when provoked, sellouts wearing the yoke. Tilling the lands on bare hands and knees for jokes. Or call in the clan, deliver a sellout to the grand wizard. Or make them lick a frozen pole during a blizzard. Or waist high in a fish tank, Piranha is riching. On my Clint Eastwood, I can't stand niggas. Don't want to mirror Moors and act like slave pitchers. Watch for Dirty Moors, they move like snake slither. Treason committed, under torture, quick to admit it. Cleverness of the righteous surprises the wicked. Wicked.
Sitting on the couch all day, just sitting here telling y'all what to do. And y'all just sitting here fat, watching them, paying for these dumbass packages. There's no sugar coating. That's what it is. That's what's happening.
Actually, lucky thing I don't have much more room to talk. I had enough to say too, you know. You guys ain't fucking with none of our leaders, bro. Not our Grand Sheik, anybody. And today Jamal got free up too. Rise of the Moors, you know what it is. We all over, worldwide, universal. Islam.
You scared to challenge the powers that be, so-called powers that be? Then go sit down somewhere. Go back to church. You know, just sit down and just... You know, go praise whoever you go praise. We don't deal with that. We deal with science. That's it. And Brother Hannibal, he's another handful. Oh, man, Hannibal, he's another humble brother. I mean, we all came, we cut from the same cloth. You know what I mean? So, you know, he's another humble brother. You know, we've been doing this for so long. You know, we're not into the game of pimping our people. That's not what we do, like most people do. You know, you got cats that pimp our people, be it, you know, they was on, you know, somewhere else, and they trying to come onto the conscious side or whatever. Whatever it's way, you know, they trying to pimp our people. That's it. We never sold paperwork to anybody. Our paperwork were free, you know, and you only paid for your documents. That's all. Our mission was always, which was put to me by Brother Taj, is to educate the people and keep it moving. You know, and that's it. That's all this movement is about. and people started seeing money in it, and people started coming towards and say, oh, we can make money off of this. You know what I mean? Oh, what's up? You know, or make a film on it, whatever. You know what I mean? Come on. And the real people are not benefiting from it.
They are, brother. And I'm going to give them the floor. I want y'all to hear me out before they say anything and do a video, right? Let them know that Sabir Bey did say he's going to let you come on, but you ain't going to rant for 30 minutes on my feed. But you can rant for 5 minutes and just get straight to the cause of the problem, bruh. What issue do you have with me? And I'm going to tell you the issue that they had with me up in Canada. Let me tell you the story. Can I tell y'all this story?
Peace. Peace to all the Moors. Before he tells the story, keep in mind, when you hear Moors, when you hear Moors refer to the jurisdiction that we're in as Canada, look at them funny. When you hear Moors, people who claim to be Moors, when they start talking, and when it comes to this jurisdiction that we're in, and they start talking about Canada instead of Canaan land, watch those Moors funny. Don't take them more serious. Because all these Moors should be honoring Canaan land. All these Moors, wherever they're at, they should have enough honor to know that Canada is a corporation. That's not a country. United States is a corporation. That's not a country. As soon as they start talking about Canada and United States, look at these Moors funny. Any Moor who's talking about Canada and not mentioning Canaan land, no, without a shadow of a doubt, we've been putting in work since 2008 as Moors out here. Since 2008, we've been putting in work, putting in serious work out here with the Moorish paradigm. When we started in 2008, no one was talking about anything Moorish out here. No one. No one. We're the reason why Moors is even being mentioned out here. We're the reason why. And if there was people talking about Moors, no one was taking them people serious. So know without a shadow of a doubt that Canaan land is Canada. And if Moors are going to be talking about this is Canada, be careful. Watch yourself. Because obviously they think this is a game. Right? Let's check this story. Check this story that he has to tell.
So, Toronto, Canada. Let me tell you, I'm going to give y'all, and if I'm lying, go share this to them right now. Let me tell you what happened. I was in Toronto, Canada, right? See, I told you, when I pay my money, I'm not obligated to go to nobody's piece, nobody's place at all.
No. We talked about this before. Any more that claims they came to Canaan land, specifically Toronto, Canaan land, and they didn't go to the Moor Science Temple of America, the first ever Moor Science Temple of America in Canaan land, watch those Moors funny. If You're talking to a Moor. And they say, oh man, I just went to Toronto. Ask them, did you call the Moors in Toronto? Like, as a Moor, when you went there, did you contact the first Moor Science Temple of America in Toronto? Like, did you reach out to them? Did you leave a voicemail, let them know you're in town? Anything? As a Moor, just ask them. But since 2008, the amount of Moors who don't live in Canaan land, they live outside of Canaan land. The amount of Moors, random Moors, now just call me, call the temple, leave a message. Yeah, I'm in town. I just wanted to check and see and try to get a hold of somebody. Random Moors, Moors I never met in my life. You know, I'm driving trucks and I was just passing through Toronto. I was just passing through on my route. So I said, let me just call the number and see if anybody's there. But Islam, you know, thanks for all you do and all that. These are Moors outside of Toronto, outside of Canaan land. These are Moors outside that made it an obligation in their life to make sure, if they say they honor Noble Drew Ali, make sure that they be in contact with, or they go visit, or they invite the Grand Sheikh to wherever they're at to show honors. It's a prerequisite. Whether they're dirty, whether they're a package seller, whether they're a traitor, whether they're a quisling, whether they're a fag, whether they're whatever. If you say that you're with Noble Drew Ali and you honor the Moorish Empire and the Moorish Nation, then when you go to Toronto, you better check the Moor Science Temple of America. You better call the number. Number's there. Trust me, we will get your message because we get the messages. And we call people back when they leave a message. Any Moors I don't care where they are. If they're competent Moors, they know about Canaan land. If they know about Canaan land, they know that the only reason that they can say Canaan land is because the Moor Science Temple of America there. Let it be known that this is Canaan land, not Canada. I went and showed you even in the slave narrative when all the slaves are escaping to Canaan. This is where the freedom was at. Free jurisdiction. Canaan land. Go ask any slave, whoever. Let them sing the hymn to you. People know that Canada is Canaan. Moors came out here for Indy, for Caravana, for All-Star Sports Weekend, for visit their cousin's grandma, for business, for just driving their truck passing through, and they reached out. They reached out to the Moors. They reached out to the Moors and gave high honors to all the Moors who are in Canaan land and inspired these Moors outside of Canaan land to be Moors. So he happened to be in Toronto. Huh? This is a story that he's just out here. What's he doing out here? What's he out for? What's he out here for? Come see his whores. Come see his Toronto sluts. That's what they're here for. 19 Keys, when he came out here, where he came out here for? The Toronto sluts. That's what they're here for. You're not coming out here to do any lectures or anything like that. Come out here for their orgies and all that. That's what they're coming out here for. You're not coming out here uplifting fallen humanity. So the part of the story that he's not telling about him being in Toronto is that we contacted him pre him coming here because we ordered the DVDs because he's planning the trip to go to wherever he's going to document for the Moors, and he's going to Morocco and he support and all that stuff. Okay, we'll buy some DVDs. You got the documentary out, so we'll buy some DVDs. Bought some DVDs. He's the one that said, I'm not going to mail these because I'm going to be out there. Are you going to be out here? What the hell are you doing out here? I ain't see no flyers or nothing like that that you're out here. You just coming to Toronto to chill? All right. Kind of weird, but all right. No problem. No, I guess. So that's why we were even interacting with him. We weren't interacting with him to try to do a lecture, or he was already going to be out here. And I'm thinking, as a Moor, I know that he's never been to the temple. So if he's a Moor and he's out here, well, damn. Why don't you just meet us at the temple? Like, why don't you meet us at the temple since you're going to be here? Nah. We have to pay him to come to the temple. He's going to be out here anyways. We're telling him, since you're bringing our DVDs and our DVDs are going in the temple anyways, right? These DVDs that we're buying from you, we're going to be putting them at the temple on the bookstore wall so we can sell them to the Moors. So meet us at the temple. Nah. Nah. If he comes to the temple, we have to pay him because he's doing the fundraiser, because he's going to Morocco and he needs the support from the Moors. And if the Moors would only support, we'd be able to get more done and all the BS. I don't know who he thought he was talking to. I don't know who he thought he was talking to. Like I'm going to fall for that BS. Like I just came into this yesterday or something. But that's how Sabir goes. You know, Sabir, he's an egomaniac. You know, he thinks he knows more than everybody else because he's been around longer or something like that. Right? Just these narcissistic tendencies that some of these Moors have. Right? So he's not coming to the temple unless We pay him. So we're like, F that. I'm not paying you to come to the temple. We already paid for our DVDs, so wherever you're at, I guess we'll just come get it from you. Since he's an egomaniac. So that's how us even interacting out here came about. It wasn't because he was, you know, here on some lecture or whatever. He was doing his own whatever he was doing. I don't know what he was doing, but he was out here.
Not obligated to go anywhere, right? So I told them to come, you know, people want to meet you when you go to places. I got all that. I'm fine with that. But I said, if I'm paying my money, don't ask me to get, when I get there, to come somewhere, unless you got to, you know, you won't cut a check for me. You know what I mean? I'm not.
Right. Stop lying. Pre him coming here, we spoke. And he wasn't going to mail the DVDs because he was going to be out here. So pre him coming here, we knew he was coming here. It wasn't like we found out he was here. And then we bumped into him and said, hey, come to the temple to do something. That's not how it went, if that's how he's trying to put it. Right. And I'm not even concerned what his trip was for. His trip could be for whatever. Getting DVD cases. Finding a distributor. I could give a shit what he was here for. All I know is that he wasn't here on some lecture or something like that, and he's doing something for the Moorish Nation. He was out here on some chilling. I'm going to go visit a place or going to go visit somebody. He was here on some vacation. He wasn't here on some doing some work for the Moors or something like that. Right? And remember, don't fall for the game that we just bumped into him out here. We knew he was going to be out here because we bought DVDs from him and he didn't want to mail it because he was going to be out here. So to save the 30 notes to mail it, he said, we'll just meet up out here. I'll just bring him with me. Fine. Ain't no big deal. You know? But to not meet us at the temple and then come and lie now and make it seem like we tried to get a free lecture from you or something like that. We ain't trying to get no free lecture from him. We don't need no lecture from him. Them times we already stopped messing with him. Why we stopped messing with him? Because pre this DVD situation with him, I personally wanted my music played on his radio show when he was in Cali. And I'm thinking, well, if he's on a radio show and he's a Moor, this should be easy to get my stuff played every day, all day. Because this is another Moor. This is another Moor who we all know the same Moors. We all know the same Moors. Like the high-level Moors. I'm not talking about the average Moor that you see. We're talking about all the teacher Moors. All of us know the same Moors. All of us know the same Moors. I'm going up there now, like, this is a Moorish brother with a radio station. Wow. Like, he's playing on the radio. This is a big thing. I want to get some music played. You know, like, what's good? Hundred notes and I'll play. 100 notes and I'll play your music. 100 notes? That's it? Shit. Here's 100 notes. 100 notes got me one play. One play, one time. From that point is when I said, fuck Sabir. From that point. And you could ask him about that because he knows and I know that I gave him 100 notes to play my music and he played one song one time. But KRS-One, who doesn't give a fuck about the Moors, he's going to play him 500 times a day. These people are liars. Their gig is up. Their gig's up. And they thought everybody's going to play the go with the program BS. At this day and time is about playing our people. And only giving them crumbs when you should be giving them the whole cake. Exactly, gatekeepers. This is what these people are. I paid and got one play. And he just sucking KRS Richard all the time. And KRS doesn't even fuck with Morris. They don't tell you about Morris' birthright, nothing. They call you a black and all that. There's many sellouts in the Moorish movement. There's many, many sellouts. Many people sold the hell out. Why? I don't know. Doesn't make sense to me. But it is what it is. People sell out. And once they sell out, they become a liar. Because they sold out. So to avoid them being called for being a sellout,
I'm there on my own. So they wanted to meet me. I think we met in Starbucks in Toronto, right? So I didn't go to where they wanted me to go.
Yeah, where we wanted him to go was the Moore Science Temple, where we were going to be keeping the DVDs that we bought from him. So instead of us having to travel twice, since you're already out here, jump in an Uber, it'll probably be 15 notes, 20 notes, and just meet us at the temple. Nah, he doesn't want to do that. We got to pay him. We have to pay him to come to the temple. Remember, all he's doing is dropping off our DVDs because we didn't care that he was going to be here. We just want to get our stuff. Since you're here, you might as well come to the temple. We've been here since 2008. You know, why don't you come visit the temple? Aren't you with the Moors and Noble Drew Ali and all that? Nah. He wants to go meet at Starbucks. So we're on Dundas Street East. And we're walking on Dundas. We're walking. Okay, where the hell is this Starbucks? He said the Starbucks on Dundas, but where the hell is this Starbucks? Walking. And then we start getting closer and closer to the street where Dundas meets and this Starbucks. And we're pulling up to Church Street. We're pulling up to Church Street. Church Street and Dundas Street East. If you didn't know, Church Street is the village out here. Church Street is the street where, when we were in high school, there was just a little scatter on that street. But everybody knew that that was those people's street. To the point where that's their own country out here, Church Street. Everything of those people is there, and you'll find it there. If you can't find it anywhere else, you know you can go to church. You know you can go to Church Street. Ask anybody from Canaan land. Hey, what's Church Street? See what they tell you. And then go ask Siri. Siri, what is Church Street in Toronto? See what Siri says. Why would this Moor want us to meet him at a Starbucks in the village instead of the Moor Science Temple? Why would a Moorish American choose, because we didn't pay him, to meet us in the village instead of the Moor Science Temple of America? If you had to meet some Moors, you go somewhere. Let's say you go to Wyoming. There's some Moors near Wyoming. And the Moors say, oh, could you meet us at the temple? When you're in Wyoming, here's the address for the temple. Just meet us at the temple on this day, since you're going to be in Wyoming. Nah, you got to pay me to come to the temple. But I'll meet you at the Starbucks in the village. Certain people, when you see certain people have children and stuff like that, it's a front. It's a front. Because I don't know why a Moor would want to meet some other Moors in the village at a Starbucks. Village at Starbucks? Instead of the Moor Science Temple? This person must be a sellout. They must be a sellout. If you're finding some justification for him meeting us in the village at a Starbucks instead of the Moor Science Temple of America, guess what? F you too. F you and him. F you and him. If you're going to justify him meeting us in the village, Starbucks, instead of the Moor Science Temple of America. And F you if you hear this and then you still go and support and follow and watch and whatever him.
They got mad. No, Nick Rose, I don't know you. So why? So this is what happened. So this same particular...
Sabir doesn't know me? Sabir doesn't know me? Sabir doesn't know Cujo? For real? Do you think he... Cujo knows Razmaraya Bay, but he doesn't know Sabir. Cujo knows Kaba Hiawatha, but doesn't... Cujo knows Jose Pimenta Bay, but Sabir doesn't know who Kudra is? Calling us Negroes and he doesn't know us and all that? How doesn't he know who we are? When we know Taj, when we know Grand Sheik Nature. We even know Bambara. You know Bambara. Even Bambara honors Canaan land. We're registered members of Zulu Nation. Got Zulu Nation pendant and all that. All the Zulu Nation is supposed to be wearing. Sabir doesn't know who. Please. Please. These people fool you because you're late to the party. You're late to the party. You're telling me what DJ played and all that stuff. You even know who the DJ is. Sellouts.
But brothers in the Canaanite Moors, they actually talked about Taj dirty. Because a lot of these Moors can't leave and go to other countries.
What does talk about Taj dirty have to do with going to other countries? And what dirty did we talk about Taj? Because I'm pretty sure we keep bringing up all these people that are around Taj and calling them dirty. That's who we're calling dirty. This is Taj is dirty by association. I don't want to lecture with somebody that's dirty. We'll be doing just go to Canaan Land Moors. Just say Canaan Land Moors, Taj Tariq Bey. Pull that up. See how much stuff we did with him. And Sabir doesn't know who we are? He's talking crazy. If we think Taj dirty, you think we have all his Skypes that we did on YouTube still? Why would we have that up there if we think he's dirty? How could I have videos up there with Taj Tariq Bey in them? But I think he's dirty. One thing is that we don't stray from the foundation. Regardless what issues people have with each other, we're neutral. Because we honor our foremothers and forefathers. When our foremothers and forefathers pull up and start being liars, bold-faced liars, nobody could say some BS about Taj Tariq Bey. Too much work got put in. I can't say BS. Too much work got put in. Nothing anybody says against him should matter. There's too much work got put in. Now there's people who go out on campaigns and try to say that he's dirty. And Sabir has nothing to say to them. But lowly old Cool Joe, just over here, just doing our own thing over here. We don't mess with none of these people. Because we've dealt with Moors and got played. We dealt with Moors and they tried to pull scams and all that stuff. We already know that there's dirty Moors in this. We don't mess with Dirty Moors. Find me something on our page that has Sabir Bey have to do with it, other than us calling him out for his BS. Find something. You'll find nothing. We don't plug him. We're doing this to show you he's a liar. And then if you want to keep messing with liars, then F you too. That's what this is for. Tell me, oh, he's an elder. You should respect him and all this stuff. Liar.
So these brothers are up in Canada. So if I'm lying, the brothers can get on the feed and tell me I'm lying. But
you don't have to go on his feed to tell you he's lying. We'll tell you right now he's lying. Like, we've been telling you that he's lying. Because he came here and wanted to meet us in the village instead of wanting to meet us at the Moore Science Temple of America. The hell are you talking about? Why is anything else even talked about? How the hell is this Moore meeting Moores in the village and not at the Moore Science Temple? And he's a Moore. Hell you talking about? The fucking village? This Moore wants to meet other Moores? Instead of the Moore Science Temple? And you're looking at that? Oh, that's all right. That's cool. At least you got your DVDs. The fuck out of here. The Moore meeting me in the village instead of the Moore Science Temple. I'm supposed to have some respect for this Moore? I don't respect these sellouts. I don't respect them. Zero. Zero. Respect these people. Talking crazy.
I wanted to take his books, right, and put them in a hardback. But it would cost money to do that. Because if you have it like this, of course you could charge $10 for those books. Of course. But the thing about it is to take these books and put them in a hardback so they won't fade. Because the color will fade, the book will fall apart, because it's no good anymore. So the other thing that you can do is also put it in a PDF, which I put the Rex 84 in the PDF. And I mail it, email it, I can email it to people. I don't have to.
So if you don't have to print anything, and if you don't have to bind anything, and if you don't have to do any of that, how is it going from 10 notes to 60 notes? How's a PDF 60 notes? The hell are you talking about? Sixty notes for King Alfred Plan. And it's a PDF. It's not even a hard copy book. Now, you could justify paying something because you gotta print, you gotta bind, you might want to do it in color, whatever. You want to make a profit, whatever.
This is what's going on with our people. They don't understand the work that goes into this. So if I wanted to sell these books, I could sell them, but I don't sell them. They're still sitting in the house. I got a whole lot of those books. They're all sitting there. I don't need to sell them. For what? Now, let me show you some more. I'm going to show them another book that they probably, and this brother right here, nobody let me say this to you. Raz Mariah wasn't even around when this brother was here. She don't even know who Kamara Gabrielle is. That's the brother that brought me into this movement. That's the 33 civic question for Morris children. Kamara Gabrielle. Didn't say Todd's. So this is the first book that Kamara gave me years ago. And if I want to, I can make that and sell that and put it in PDF form. He gave me permission years ago to do that. But I choose not to. You follow me? Because I'm not about doing...
So the author gave you permission to spread this word, and then you still didn't do it. They told me this person's not a sellout. Author gave him permission to copy it, give it away, do whatever. What's he doing? Sitting on it. And they want to talk about he's for the Moors. He's for the Moors. Author giving him permission to put out work and he's not putting it out. You want to know what's wrong with the Moorish movement?
People wrong. Like these greedy ass Moors that's out here. That try everything. Even down to my documentary on Noble Drew Ali. These Negroes then took my video and have not produced any video on Noble Drew Ali since. But you best believe they told me a lot of people all over, even up in Canada, was selling my documentary. Why haven't no more did a documentary on Noble Drew Ali? I'm asking the question. So... I'm just saying.
What do you mean? Why hasn't Amor done a documentary on Noble Drew Ali when he's Amor and did a documentary on Noble Drew? You missing it? How is he gonna say out of his mouth? How come no more did a documentary on Noble Drew Ali? When he is a Moor and he did a documentary on Noble Drew Ali. What are these people smoking? Or are they just sellouts? They're not even talking to make sense because they know the people are dumb. They're not even talking to make sense because they know people are a dumbass. And they'll believe anything that any goofball out here has to say. Because they're not going to go fact check anything.
They love Noble Drew Ali, right? They should have did a documentary. I didn't have no money when we did not the documentary on Noble Drew Ali. For y'all that don't understand it, I'm going to show y'all. Here it is right here. This is before there was a Hidden Colors. So you even got to commend Tariq Nasheed for doing what he did, but let me help y'all out. You see that says Superior Bay Productions right there, right? Oh, but they would skip that part and say, no, I don't want to. It's the Superior Bay. The video ain't nothing. But then you produce something. But let me show y'all this video. But they love to tell y'all crazy stuff and what I'm doing. But this is what I...
Now shut up!
Yo, where you at? It is...
If I wasn't running around, then I was square and I couldn't get down. But I was just find my guy. Girl, you were out of sight. But if you just say the word, oh, I'll be there.
There They're not business-minded people, brother. This is insane. If you love Noble Drolet, produce that for Noble Drolet. What YouTube? It's so my video.
It's all about the fucking something. That's where we are.
Brother, it ain't nothing, brother.
The unraveling of the greatest mystery on planet Earth. The mystery of the hidden God.
I'm going to know all of them. I'm going to do this for our people, brother. That's why I open up the law and mental health. Good. This means my people. I'm going to
help. May seem. Don't give up our plans. Don't give up our dreams.
No
broken bridges can turn us around. Cause what we're searching for will soon be found. Cause we're all almost there.
Get it off, baby.
Just one more step. Just one more step. Don't give up. We're all
giving them the opportunity, bro.
Look at the lonely lovers that didn't make it long.
So we're going to stop that. So this is what it is, bro. When we did that video, that was random with no money, no budget. So you can't tell me that you're getting $3,000 to $4,000. You can't do a documentary on the man that y'all talk about. So my brother, he said, yeah, he has a sure mental illness. Yes, he do. He really do. But my thing is with people, I want you to hear me out. When dudes be typing stuff, I'm going to give you 5 minutes to hit the link and come on here. 5 minutes. Mel Jackson is, yes, he's from Soul Food. Oh, you caught that? Yeah, Mel Jackson is from Soul Food. And he was the one that told me that I should do this. And this is what a lot of Moors are upset about. Oh, they upset. That's what they upset about, brother. It ain't because they can apply themselves too.
No, we're upset that you wanted to meet us in the village instead of the Moor Science Temple of America. That's what we're upset about. We're upset that you as a Moor always pushing KRS-One, who doesn't give a shit about Moors, when there's Moors artists that you could play. If you're a Moor, why are you playing a black guy if you're a Moor? Or are you some dick rider and all you're doing is looking for the fame and nobility, rub elbows with people, have you looking good and traveling all over the world while your people suffer and die, like all the rest of them? You're just in the conscious side. Just in the side of the people that know. Playing games. Creating BS. How come you won't address, why were you in the village? Why are we meeting you in the village? Why is that the spot for us to meet you at, when we could have met at the Moor Science Temple of America as Moors? What would that have done in the ethers? These Moors meeting at the Moor Science Temple of America. This Moor taking his product, putting it in the store of the Moor Science Temple of America. He wants to meet in the village. That's what we're mad about. We care less about a Noble Drolet documentary. The hell we need Noble Drolet documentary before when we have his literature. What we need is, what you need a documentary of Noble Drew Ali for. And Amor Sabir Bey already did a documentary on Noble Drew Ali. What are we going to be doing? Going and recreating the wheel. What are we doing a documentary on Noble Drew Ali for? Again. Amor already did it. Amor did it already.
But you got to be a business-minded person. He said, somebody said, produced by Mel Jackson from Soul Food. Yup. And Mel, the funny part is, Mel didn't even produce it. Mel just encouraged me, but I give the credit where the credit is due at. That's what I do. If Yoel did something, I'm going to say Yoel did this. And I may get mad at Yoel sometimes, but I say, yo, Yoel did do this. Because he's like a big brother to me. And he checks me too sometimes. I can't lie. He do. But this is what happens. This is what we got to start doing, B. And if I'm lying about anything, all you got to do is jump on the link and come on and tell me. And what happened, brother Yoel? I was.
No, we don't have to jump on your thing to tell you you're a liar. We don't have to do that. We don't have to do that. Be open-minded. Be open-minded to the idea that every Moore is not your boy. Every Moore is not your boy. Every Moore is not your people. Some of these Moors out here are about their selfish self. They can care less about you. Now, peep game. Peep game.
Talking about when I was in Canada, this is why the brothers was got upset. I don't go to places. If I spend my money to go somewhere, I want to, you know, I'm not obligated to go there. Because you didn't pay me to come in. I think that's how it go, right? So if I go somewhere, it has to be me getting paid.
If he goes somewhere, it was for him getting paid. He just said that he's going to go wherever he wants to go. And he wasn't going to come to the Morris Science Temple of America to drop off the DVDs that we brought. He wanted to meet us in the village because we wouldn't pay him to come to the temple as if we need him to do a lecture or something. Like we're some fuck niggers that need him as our teacher. We don't need him as our teacher. We don't need him to give us no lecture. Sabir Bey is no one to us when it comes to teaching us something. You ever notice he didn't make the Moore Avengers? How come he's not in there? He's been around just as long as everybody who's in there. How come he's not in there? Because he's a sellout, that's why. And everybody knows it. Everybody knows he still gets his checks from when he got shot and all that stuff. Why is he asking you for finance? Stop the BS. We paid for the DVDs. He was dropping them off here because he was going to be here. We don't need him for a lecture. We don't need him for a lecture. What we need him for a lecture for? Honors to all the Moors worldwide. Here's the countdown. Peace and love to all the Moors in the chat. Honors to all the mothers. All the mothers and honors to Prophet Noble Drew Ali. Peace and love to all the Moors. Fuck Sabir Bey.